Shredded arugula and white truffled curried creme, pan-seared with smoked chanterelle. Truly succulent basil peach chutney potato. Chutney. Excellent choice, sir.
You want anything on that?
No.
See, life doesn't have to be so complicated. A simple reminder from Kellogg's Corn Flakes. Simple is good.
Now your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Goes out with a bang as severe weather rolls through the Midwest and the heat is on in the South. Those stories plus in-depth forecast and analysis on this edition of Weather Center.
It was another day of dangerous heat across the South. Good evening, I'm Kim Perez. Thank you for joining us. You may want to plan an indoor dinner for Dad tomorrow as the sweltering temperatures continue. More on that in the forecast. But we begin tonight with the severe weather in the Midwest. For that, let's go to Sharon Resultan in the Forecast Center.
Thanks a lot, Kim. The activity continues to pop now across the central and southern plain states, and it also continues in the Midwest. We'll start you out first showing you the area that's going to be under the gun for the next several hours. And in fact, for some of you, on into the overnight, the areas in red indicating where we think the best chances are for severe weather as we go through that time period right on into early Sunday morning. Within that region, there are some weather watches in effect, a severe thunderstorm watch encompassing much of southern Wisconsin into extreme northern Illinois, and tornado watches that do include Kansas City and Topeka and work their way down through Oklahoma City and back into North Texas. Looking at just one radar perspective, you can see how the thunderstorms are stretching from southwestern Wisconsin through central Iowa, particularly strong into northeastern Kansas. There are numerous severe thunderstorm warnings associated with them, but notice how the activity has moved out of Minneapolis. Minneapolis, you saw the action before you really even got a chance to get any of that daytime heating. Now, these scenes were shot at mid-morning when the first round of storms rolled through the area. As you can see, the heavy rain slowed traffic just a bit, causing a few motorists to pull over and literally wait it out. And that sometimes that's the best advice we can give you in that sort of situation. Let's go back to the radars here. This is a very impressive radar. As you can see, the strong storms that are pushing through Sauk and Iowa counties into southwestern Wisconsin. You can also see the severe weather here north and east of Topeka. Now let me zoom in a little bit closer. Look on the far right-hand side of your screen here, and you'll see some of the activity that is now occurring into southwestern Wisconsin, and then these thunderstorms that are moving now into extreme northwestern Missouri. We'll want to keep an eye particularly on into Atchison County, Jackson County, and Jefferson counties in northeastern Kansas, and then we'll be watching areas like Buchanan County and Platte County in northwestern Missouri, maybe for some action there in the next hour and a half or so. You're looking now at a radar down toward Oklahoma City. Now, there are numerous severe thunderstorm warnings associated with this. We did have a tornado warning in effect for Kingfisher County. That expired as of the bottom of the hour. We continue to watch cells popping up to the north of Oklahoma City and to the west of Oklahoma City, and we'll continue to watch these as they move to the east at about 10 miles per hour. They're not exactly in a big hurry, so these could be big rain producers, which in turn could mean some localized flooding across this region as well. We expand the picture a bit more. You'll be able to see as we head down into North Texas, areas like Shackelford County and Callahan County, also some severe thunderstorm warnings in effect. This cell here actually broke into two separate cells, but earlier was capable of producing up to golf ball and baseball size hail and winds up to around 70 miles per hour. So some pretty nasty thunderstorms where we have some of the higher dew points heading into the southern plain states. Again, everything developing along and ahead of our cold front, which is going to continue to meander off to the east here. Not a lot of action in and around Missouri as of yet. We had some rain earlier in the day, but along the outflow boundaries, we think we may find a few more thunderstorms developing a little bit later on, and we'll watch too for the potential into eastern Kansas and western Missouri for a big complex to set up, and that may last through the night across that region, so we'll keep an eye out for that. But in the meantime, just keep in mind, well, we have these really, really high dew points, a lot of low-level moisture. Expect to find the potential for strong storms and some very, very heavy rain, and the severe threat will be in some of the same areas even on into your Father's Day. Look out into the upper Midwest and Central Plains as we head into Sunday. If you're away from your television set but would like further information, you can reach us at weather.com. We take it back to the studio now with word on some active weather too in and around Nashville with Kim.
Thanks, Sharon. We'll be showing you a radar of Nashville. We have a tornado warning in effect that should be expiring here momentarily, and we'll take a look there. But some parts of Florida and northern Florida got some heavy rain last night, but it wasn't nearly enough to put down the record heat or the danger of fires. For firefighters, it was another day of working through oppressive heat. These pictures are from Volusia County, Florida. It's about halfway between Daytona Beach and Orlando. Heat indices over 100 degrees complicated the situation. Lightning sparked more than 30 fires across the state today. That's right. We actually are looking at some of the showers and thunderstorms dying down here in Florida. We still have a few warnings out there, and we'll pass along to you. But you can see most of the activity here over Georgia. Not Georgia, but Alabama, and into Tennessee tonight. And off the northeast, still a little bit of light rain out there. We're going to talk about that too. But let's concentrate where the severe weather is happening, and it's here across Alabama and Florida, and even into Tennessee. As a matter of fact, with this cell right here, we continue to have a tornado warning in effect. Here is Davidson County. Here is Wilson County and Rutherford County here off to the south. You are now under a tornado warning in Rutherford County. And Wilson County, or Davidson County, I think that expired maybe a couple of minutes ago here at 7:30 Central Time. So it looks like now the most active weather moving into Wilson County and then into Rutherford County, northern Rutherford County. So folks, you should be seeking shelter immediately. Okay, we'll keep you posted on the active weather here around Nashville. But otherwise, heavy rain in southern Alabama and in northern Florida tonight. Again, yesterday, remember, the same area is getting hit. And around the peninsula, the afternoon sea breeze kicked in, a few thunderstorms developed, but it looks like that is starting to taper off also. Okay, from Montgomery all the way southward into the Florida panhandles where we're seeing the showers and thunderstorms out there tonight. As a matter of fact, we have a severe thunderstorm warning in effect for Jones County in Mississippi right here. And we also have one for Harrelson County in central, well, at least extreme western Georgia. Harrelson County under a severe thunderstorm warning. I don't have a radar to show you that, but that's north of Columbus. You're under a severe thunderstorm warning at this time. Looks like Panama City, most of the action's been off to your east, but some of this could fill in, so you might want to just keep an umbrella handy and watch the skies if you're out at the beach tonight, if you plan on taking a walk out there. But around Orlando, still a little bit of light rain out there. The thunderstorm's weakening, but unfortunately, the thunderstorms didn't make it in there before you got to 98 degrees today, tying the record. And Tampa also tying the record at 97. And once again, Melbourne, like 15 days now, 16 days in June that you have broken or tied the record. Unbelievable. The heat is on, that's for sure. 89 right now in Tampa. And look how the triple digits just take over parts of Texas again. Unbelievable. Very oppressive. Exercise caution if you're out there doing some exercising or playing ball or something. Drink lots of water. In the Northeast, look at 61 in Boston. Boy, that sounds nice to you folks here in the South, doesn't it? Well, actually, you've been having to deal with some cloud cover and some rainfall here, too. So it's not too nice, really. But you know what? Good news, and we'll show you that in the forecast here in a few minutes. But actually, This should be the end of it. After tonight, it should be a better weather for you folks here in the Northeast. The West Coast, beautiful, beautiful day today. San Diego, Phoenix, great day today. Temperatures will be about in the 70s, upper 70s or so in Phoenix.
He gave me a hard time, then he took it. Big baby. Yeah, Unisil. What the pharmacist said. I know it's not habit forming. He's the one who made a big deal. Want to say hi? He sent his regards.
All right.
You too.
Now your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Spring goes out with a bang as severe weather rolls through the Midwest and the heat is on in the South. Those stories plus in-depth forecast and analysis on this edition of Weather Center.
We're following a line of strong storms moving through the Midwest tonight. Good evening, I'm Christina Abernathy.
And I'm Paul Emick. You know, parts of Florida need a little relief and they got some today in the form of rain, but many others are still very hot and dry. We'll talk more about this coming up, too, but also the Father's Day forecast just a few moments away. First, we need to talk about some severe weather that's going on right now, and for that, we'll go to the Forecast Center with Sharon Rizzoldi. Sharon?
Thanks a lot, Christina. And Paul, you know, the severe weather tonight is scattered all the way from the upper Midwest back down into the southern plain states and into North Texas. There is a widespread area that could see severe weather during the overnight. Let's go ahead and take a look at it. And of course, the areas in red marking where we think conditions are most likely for the development of strong to severe thunderstorms going into the next several hours, and indeed for some of you, perhaps on into the overnight as well. Not out of the woods necessarily in and around Chicago or Kansas City or even into St. Louis. We'll be keeping an eye on all of those locations. Let's show you the watch area once again, and there they are, extending from southern Wisconsin all the way back down into North Texas. The red, of course, indicating where tornadoes are a possibility, and the yellow where severe thunderstorms are more likely. There's a look at the line of thunderstorms as it has been passing through the upper Midwest. Notice it's out of Minneapolis. These are some scenes out of Minneapolis. You folks saw your rainfall come down a little bit earlier. Matter of fact, the thunderstorms didn't even wait for the afternoon heat in Minneapolis today. These scenes were shot at mid-morning when the first round of storms moved on through. As you can see, the heavy rain slowed traffic down just a bit, causing some motorists to pull over and wait it out. Well, that's the scene out of Minneapolis. Again, this is what the radar looks like now. Most of those showers and thunderstorms stretching through western Wisconsin, they have weakened quite a bit. What you see there into central Illinois, not really much of a problem either. And then into northwestern Missouri and northeastern Kansas, some of these storms have been on the severe side. So those are the areas that we're watching. Let me take you all the way down into the central and southern plain states. You will find more development in and around Cowley County and Sumner County of Kansas. Severe thunderstorm warnings in effect there, just expiring around Oklahoma County near Oklahoma City. then again, heading just around the Abilene area, some stronger thunderstorms that have been producing up to golf ball to baseball size hail. So we'll start things out here first into the southern plain states, and you'll get a better view of some of these thunderstorms. In and around Canadian County, we've had some severe weather. These are particularly nasty, and again, you could see some damaging winds associated with those as they slowly move to the east. Those are actually moving to the east at only around 5 to 10 miles per hour. Matter of fact, that storm around Sumner County being reportedly stationary, not moving very much. So therein lies the next problem of possibility for localized flooding. Again, we head into northeastern Kansas, and we do have into Leavenworth County a severe thunderstorm warning in effect, and Platte County heading into northwestern Missouri. Now, I want to caution you folks watching from the Kansas City area. These will be moving into downtown Kansas City within the next half hour to an hour, so watch out for some dangerous lightning, and we have had some hail associated with these storms, and there's a closer inspection. Again, St. Joseph getting some heavy rain at this time. This is again going to continue to move to the southeast at about 30 miles per hour, so it will be moving into the Kansas City area within the next hour. Our final stop with the radars takes us on up into the upper Midwest. Again, we'll find our system, our line of storms weakening a bit. But I will mention that we've had up to marble-sized hail with these thunderstorms as they head off to the east. So watch out around Madison. These are heading toward you. Again, in and around U of W campus, you're going to find some pretty hefty winds and the possibility for some hail with that particular cell as well. As far as Chicago is concerned, well, there's still some activity out to your west, but it'll be a long time before we see any of that heading on in. Possibility that some of those storms heading into Chicago could be on the strong side much later on tonight. We'll be keeping an eye out for that. There is the frontal system. Again, the thunderstorms lining up along and ahead of the front. Notice we don't have a whole lot of action here into central Missouri at this point in time. Earlier on, we had some pretty hefty amounts of rain, and we think we may find a development of a cluster of thunderstorms into eastern Kansas, west of Missouri later on, perhaps lasting through the overnight. So therein lies the other potential problem, the threat for flooding. We have a lot of low-level moisture. The dew points are quite high. And we have already seen quite a bit of rainfall into central and southeastern sections of Missouri, some areas 4 and 5 inches of rain. So we will have to watch out for the potential for flooding as we go through the overnight. Severe weather threat is also still there into the upper Midwest, down through Missouri as we head on into your Sunday. Again, if you can do a little camping in the Ozarks, for instance, you'll want to pack along the weather radio and keep an eye peeled to the sky. If you're away from your television set but would like more information, you can reach us at weather.com. Back to the studio now with Paul.
Earlier today, we saw a few showers popping up around parts of Florida. But a lot of areas, especially the northern part of the state, just really are like a virtual tinderbox. Firefighters, it was another day of working through oppressive heat here. These pictures are from Volusia County, Florida. That's about halfway between Daytona Beach and Orlando. The heat is indices over 100.